took me a while to figure it out because they had all these different, like, where we'd have to repeat the things, but then that wasn't really working for me because I didn't really know the spelling, and then Spanish is different when you pronounce stuff also, so that didn't really help me. And then I tried writing stuff down, and that kind of helped me a little more. And then from there, I kind of just developed into doing different games, which actually helped me a lot more because I like to do games at home with my family and stuff, or like matching up words or practicing note cards. That sometimes helps me too.
Well, I've always had a learning problem because I have an ear issue, so the way I hear things and see them are a little different. So when I took Spanish my freshman year, I struggled really bad. So then over the summer, I decided that I was going to spend a lot of time doing Spanish stuff and figuring out like what works best for me. And I tried a lot of different things. And so I found out that color coding was a very good thing for me, and writing it out really helped. And learning the Spanish alphabet and how to say them in Spanish and in English, that also really helped me too. But it took a lot of different things for me to try, but I finally figured it out.
So sometimes she'll be like, oh, you have to make note cards with the front and the back, but then also addition to that, we might do a project, or sometimes she'll be just like, these are what you have to do. You have to include the IR, AR, and ER groups, and then we can do whatever we want. So I just did the matching and the different descriptions.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, mm-hmm. She says, okay, you have to include this, this, and this. She doesn't really care how you have it on there. You just have to include it in there, so.
Well, I have biology right now, and we're learning about the climate and the different types of environments and habitats. And so I actually like to draw out the habitat and then kind of label it and then do different words around the edges about what is within that habitat. That helps me. So I like to use this for a lot of different classes, but then it's sometimes harder for me to use it with like math, because that's more so equations and stuff. So that's more so just writing it out like on note cards or a piece of paper and practicing it.
I use mine for math because I struggle really bad with math, and it takes me a really long time to learn math stuff too. So a lot of like these things like writing it out or coming up with like fun games to play, that really helps me learn that stuff. But yeah, it takes me a really long time to learn things in math. So a lot of these games really help me with that, so.
For homework, sometimes just the regular like practicing and writing it out sometimes doesn't work for me. So like I've made like note cards in the past where I've done the different English word and then the different forms of it on the back. And then also like sometimes I would do the Spanish word and then I would write the English definition on the side, and then if I needed to, I could also just practice it with my knowledge.
Some things that I did, because for me writing it out really helps, but I have to write it out like a whole bunch of times. So I wrote like a whole bunch of like English, and then I wrote on the back in Spanish. And I have like a whole bunch of other examples, and like even in class, like for Sarah and a Star, it took me a really long time to understand that. So I kind of had to like write a whole bunch of examples down for that. And then before like tests, I really had to write them out. So I have like examples like that. And then, yeah, here's another one of me writing a whole bunch of stuff out, so.
One game I made up is Ve Pez, which is Go Fish. And so I had different forms of each word. There was four pairs of each form. And so then people would have to be like, do you have go see, I see? And then they have to be like, and then they have to know it in the Spanish form because that's what it's written in. And then they either say go, they pez, or they grab, or they give them the cards. And another thing I did was I would write out the different forms of each thing, but then I would also draw a picture. So then it would help me have a mental image for tests, because that's what I like to see. Like when I think of a thing, I'm like trying to picture where everything was that I saw it. And so if I actually have a picture, that helps me better to actually see and understand it.
I also do pictures for some of the verbs, the ones that I had like a little difficult time remembering, like pretty seer, like all the conjugations, I had a hard time remembering it, so I do like a picture of a factory. I kind of tried to picture like each conjugation with like a package coming out of it. And then another drawing was I drew a brain for saber, and each part of the brain stood for like a different conjugation. And then for the yogo, I drew this. And this is, I had a really hard time with Yogo, so I just kind of had to like mess around with it, write a whole bunch of stuff down over and over again, make it look creative, and I had to color code a lot of it too, because that's how I learn by color coding a lot of stuff too, so.
Another thing we did is more so as a project, but it still helped us learn, was we made a video. It was a 5-minute video, and we made it almost as a storybook someone was telling, and it helped us learn the different forms of like the present, like we went, we go, we see, we constructed, we destroyed, and all that stuff. And then also, one thing I like to do is I learned the AR, IR, and ER verbs. And so I did the different forms of it. And then I also did like different words for like examples. And then like the different colored endings is the different conjugations of that word. And then on the back, I did different words like I went, and then you have to match it up with fue. And so you would just circle it and you would try to draw a line without touching all the other lines. So it's more so a competition against someone. But you also it also helps you memorize the words.
And another thing that I did was like, because there's a whole bunch of like mazes and crossword puzzles and word searches. So what I did, I made like a whole bunch of stuff like in Spanish. And so for this, I have like, here's like your key, you have to follow it in English. And you find it in Spanish on here and it'll lead you to the end. And I have like a whole bunch of those. And then a couple other things I did was like crossword puzzles, but I didn't bring any. But I just made them all in Spanish, so.
I would also make practice tests because that would help me prepare for the test, like kind of give me an idea what it's like. So like I would have the different forms and then like the English phrases and then have to write the Spanish phrases on the side. And then I also made some Kahoots where I just had the English, I would have the English words or I'd ask what are the different forms of, and then I would just play that against either a friend or a sibling because that would help me then practice.
A couple things that I did, I created like some games. And so I wrote like all these different verbs in Spanish on note cards, and I put them on my target, which is a deer, looks like that. And so I did this thing where I had a dice, and there's 5 things on a dice, and so 1 stood for yo, 2 stood for 2, and then 3 stood for L or Asia. And then so I just picked a card for like the verb and stuff, and I rolled the dice. And then whatever one that was, I shot the deer. And this was for like nights, like when I was really busy and I didn't have time to sit on the computer and wait for the computer to load. So I just created that game. And then another game that I created was, it's a spelling game. It's kind of like a spelling bee sort of. And it involves beach balls. And I created these beach balls, and like on each thing there's a verb or whatever. And so you get in like a group of like 8 people and you throw the beach ball. And when you catch it, whatever like your right thumb verb lands on, you have to conjugate it. And so you have to say the verb, and then you have to spell it, and then you have to say it again. And there's a couple other games that I made up, so.
I know a lot of the class, they like to actually make Kahoots or Quizlets, because I think that's easier for them to go on the internet and just type up the definition of the word and then the Spanish word, and that I think that's what most of the kids in our class do, or most of them will just make note cards. And for us, it's better for us to do projects, I feel like, because we just understand it better, because we put time and effort into projects more so than we do note cards. So we learn better than when we do projects.
Yeah, because you spend more time when you do projects, so you have to learn the verb when you do that, so.
Well, for them, because their system probably might not be our system, so for them, it's probably just trial and error. Like, if it helps them to better watch videos on YouTube about how to even actually hear someone say that stuff, then go do that. But it took us a lot of practicing, so like we had to figure out what worked best for us, and that's what they have to do also. And so just like either writing it down, making projects, you just have to put you have to want to care, you have to put the time and the effort into figuring out what works for you.
I would say like if you're struggling, don't like freak out, don't get angry, just take a deep breath. And for some people it takes a longer time for them to learn things. That doesn't mean that you're stupid or anything. It just means it's just gonna take a little bit more time than other people. And if you work really hard, you will definitely succeed. And the most important thing that you see is progress, that, oh, hey, I went from here and now I'm all the way up here. And even if you move slower than the rest of your class, that is okay. But as long as you find something that helps you learn, and that might take you a while too, and like what she said,